So we're going to take the derivative of natural log of 3x plus 7 over 4x minus 2. So our h prime of x, the first thing we'll have, is 1 over whatever we're taking the natural log of. 3x plus 7 over 4x minus 2. That's the first half. That's the derivative of the outside, because the outside function here is natural log. Times the derivative of the inside. So let's use some notation here. We're going to take the derivative still of 3x plus 7 over 4x minus 2. So that's going to require a quotient rule. Now here, since we have 1 over a fraction, we can flip it and multiply. So that just becomes 4x minus 2 over 3x plus 7. And now we're going to take the derivative of the inside. So, quotient rule says we start off with the denominator untouched, so 4x minus 2 times the derivative of the numerator, which is 3. 3x plus 7, its derivative is 3. Quotient rule is minus, now 3x plus 7 over times, derivative of the denominator, which is just 4, all over the denominator squared. So we're going to have some canceling we can do. We can cancel one of these 4x minus 2's out with this one. And we're going to simplify what's in the parentheses now. So we distribute the 3. So we have 12x minus 6. And I distribute the 4 as well as the negative sign. So 4 times 3x is 12x. Times a negative is a negative 12x. 4 times 7 is 28. And times a negative is negative 28, all over 3x plus 7 times 4x minus 2. The 12x's on top cancel, and it looks like we're going to have a negative 34 over 3x plus 7 times 4x minus 2. I wouldn't worry about multiplying those together. I think that's pretty simplified how we have it. For number 9 here, we got a product, e to the 7x, and then the log base 2. So we're going to use product rule in finding r prime of x. So we'll start with the derivative of the first, which is e to the 7x times the derivative of the exponent, so times 7. Now we leave the second alone. Log base 2 of 6x. Plus, now I'm going to leave the e to the 7x alone. Now we're going to multiply by the derivative of the log base 2 of 6x. Now for a derivative of a log, it's 1 over what we're taking the log of, times the derivative of the inside, so times the derivative of 6x, or times 6. Now the only thing is, because this isn't a natural log, we also have to multiply by 1 over the natural log of 2. And that's what changes the base. Let's see what kind of simplifying we can do. The 6's will cancel. And we can pull an e to the 7x out. So we pull the e to the 7x out. We are left with 7 log base 2 of 6x plus, now we pulled the e to the 7x out, 1 over x times the natural log of 2. That's going to be about as much simplifying as we can do there. Finally, we're going to look at 16 and taking the derivative of a logistic function. Best thing to do is rewrite it as 200 times 1 plus 20,000 e to the negative 0.0569t to the negative 1. Because now we can use our general chain rule. So p prime of t, we're going to have the 200. Now we can start our chain rule. So first is derivative of the outside. So first thing we've got to do is pull that exponent out front. So negative 1 times, we leave the inside alone, 1 plus 20,000 e to the negative 0.0569t raised to the negative 2, decrease the power by 1. Now we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside. The derivative of 1 is 0, plus, now the derivative of this part is an exponential, so it's going to be 20,000. It's going to have itself in it, e to the negative 0.0569t times the derivative of the exponent, so times negative 0.0569. And we now have our derivative. It is a little messy, and there's not a whole lot of simplifying we could do, because that's zero, we don't need to write that, and we can multiply this by the front, but there's not going to be a lot that we're going to end up doing. Let's see, if we wanted to, we can multiply the 200, the 20,000, and the 0.0569 together. There's a negative here and a negative here, so it'll come up positive. So that'll give us 227,600 e to the negative 0.0569t. And if we wanted to, we could write it as over 1 plus 20,000 e to the negative 0.0569t, that whole quantity squared. That's about as simplified as we're going to get.